I'm going to read a short statement, then I'll be available for some questions. Thank you for being here. I realize this is an issue that attracted attention of many people across the country. I appreciate the seriousness of the events of July 16th and the need for people to hear from me directly. None more so than the Cambridge Police Department and the members of this community. I stand behind this department and all the people that work in the city every day to ensure the safety of its residents. This is a difficult time for the department, Sergeant Crowley, and his family. This department has worked hard to continually improve its reputation in the community. I am proud of the relationships that we have built with community groups, community leaders, and the residents of an economically, educationally, and ethically diverse city. I will continue my commitment to the city, to lead the department whose mission is to serve this city, and to do everything in my power to keep it safe. I believe that Sergeant Crowley acted in a way that is consistent with his training at the department and consistent with national standards of law enforcement protocol. I do not believe his actions in any way were racially motivated. I have long held the view that every interaction has potential to teach us lessons in how we conduct ourselves, both professionally and personally. I certainly feel that way now. I believe that everyone regretted this incident, even occurred. I cannot imagine the outcome is one that anyone is happy with, and I am confident that we will find ourselves in a much better place after we have greater perspective. I am also mindful every day how easy it is to evaluate an incident after it has occurred and make judgments. This is an opportunity to re-examine our policies and procedures, and I am confident that good will come out of this unfortunate situation that we deeply regret occurred. I'm in the process of forming a panel of independent notable professionals to join us in an analysis of July 16th incident, and I invite them to review the entire incident, make recommendations on improvements that can be made. I look forward to that process, and I want to reassure the community that the department will make records, documentation, and staff available for that panel. I anticipate that this will be a way for the community to provide input, and a final report will be available for public review. In the meantime, I believe that we should let the process develop, and I ask the media to be respectful of the Crowley family. I'll take a few questions at this time.
Sergeant Crowley has done nothing wrong. What can you learn from this? What can you do differently?
Every time we look at a situation, and especially a situation of this magnitude, I believe that there was always a better way of doing something in the future. And I think we take this opportunity, it would be a mistake not to take this opportunity to re-examine it and figure out how we do things in a better way so we can de-escalate situations.
The United States said last night he called the actions of the Cambridge Police Department, they acted, quote, stupidly. Your response to the President of the United States?
My response is that this department is deeply pained and takes its professional pride seriously. And the department is basically very much taking this seriously. And I think, again, at the end of this process, we have a much stronger police department because of this crisis.
What the president said, though, Commissioner?
I believe that, again, I think this it deeply hurts the pride of this agency and that we take our professional career seriously.
If Sergeant Crowley acted by the book and you stand by what he did, why did you drop the charges?
We basically felt that this was a situation that we needed to move on from, that we didn't want this to be a prolonged situation, and we needed to focus back on what we do in terms of providing safety and protection for this community.
So, Professor Gates has called your Sergeant Crowley a rogue cop. He did so on national television.
Sergeant Crowley is a stellar member of this department. I rely on his judgment every day. He's got a long career. He's grown up in the city. He grew up in a very diverse community, and I don't consider him a rogue cop in any way. I think he basically did the best with the situation presented to him. He was thrusted into a crime in progress, as it was reported, and he tried to work his way through that situation.
Is
there been any
considering any kind of apology?
Have there been any complaints against him in the past?
We are checking our records now to see if there's any formal complaints that were lodged against Sergeant Crowley.
How about any commendations?
Sergeant Crowley has been widely recognized. In fact, he is one of our certified instructors in the department. And again, he's got a job of responsibility, and he exercises a great deal of independent judgment every day.
The department officers to arrive on the scene were, if I understand correctly, were Latino and African American. What have they told you?
Well, we're back. We're going to cut back from that because I think the announcement's been made. It seems to me, Lynn Sweet and Helene Cooper, that the Cambridge Police Department taking this seriously. They're standing by their man, the Sergeant Crowley, who was engaged in that incident last night with the professor at Harvard.